गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल बीएससी फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ फिजिकल साइंस बॉयज, ड्यूरिंग लास्ट पार्ट वी हैव सीन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ गिल इन वेलेगुआटु। वी हैव स्टडिंग द रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम ऑफ वेलेगुआटु एज लेक्चर्ड ऑफ द अदर फिशेज। वेलेगुआटु is also respire with the help of the gills, and gills are the respiratory organs in Veleagoatu or in fishes. Last part we have seen the structure of gills in Veleagoatu. Today we have continue this structure of gills, the next part of the gill or the content which is to be present in this part. Structure of gills: the bony arch bearing the gill rackers on the pharyngeal side, bony arch bearing the gill rackers on the pharyngeal side. Interbranchial or the gill septum is short and reduced with blood vessels and nerves from the gill head. These interbranchial septum or the gill septum is short and reduced with blood vessels and nerves from the gill head. Each branchial arch bears two gill filaments. Each branchial arch bears two gill filaments consisting of two hemibranchs or one holobranchs. Each set makes a half gill called demibranchs or hemibranch. Each set of gill, each half part of the gill formed a structure, and that half part of the gill which is to be called as demibranchs or hemibranchs. Hemi means half, half gill part. While when both these hemibranchs or demibranchs forms a complete set, while both the sets are attached to a gill arch, and it is gill septum or interbranchial septum, these are to be constitute complete gill or whole gill, it is to be called as the holobranchs. Hemibranchs or demibranchs, half part of the gill filament from one side and half part of the gill filament from other side. When these two half part, these are to be attached to each other, when these are to be complete to each other by gill rackers and gill arch, and forms a complete set of gill, that complete set of gill is called as the holobranchs. As the interbranchial septum are reduced, the gill filaments hang out freely into the branchial chambers. In Veleagoatu, this interbranchial septum, these are to be reduced short, and due to this interbranchial septum, these are to be reduced and short, the gill filament, these are to be hang out freely inside the branchial chamber or the gill chamber, and these gill chamber or the gill filament which is to be hanging, these gill filament, these are to be take active part in gaseous exchange, gaseous absorption, that is from the blood carbon dioxide, these are to be diffuses, and in water those dissolved oxygen is to be present, that dissolved oxygen, these are to be absorbed by these gill lamellae or the gill filaments. The gill rays partly bony and partly cartilaginous. And are attached to the branchial arch by adductor muscles orally and ligaments aborally. These gill filaments are to be partly bony and partly cartilaginous, and these gill filaments, these are to be attached to the branchial arch. This attachment of gill filaments to the branchial arch by the adductor muscles orally and ligament to the aborally. The gill rays have shallow grooves on their inner side for the primary afferent vessels and several small apertures from the secondary afferent vessels. These afferent vessels, these are to be supply the impure blood to the gill filaments for purification. The gill rays have shallow grooves on their inner side for the primary afferent vessels and several small apertures for the secondary afferent vessels. These are to be carry the impure blood or the deoxygenated blood from the dorsal aorta and supply blood to the branchial arches or the gills for purification. And in this way, these gill lamellae are to be partly bony and partly cartilaginous, and these are to be attached around the branchial arch, and these are to be attached by adductor muscle orally and ligaments aborally, and these are to be formed a number of afferent vessels, primary afferent vessels and secondary afferent vessels, and these primary and secondary afferent vessels, these are to be connected to the gill filaments, and these are to be supply blood to the purification from dorsal aorta to the gill filament. See the figure. In this figure, lateral view of head showing gills and branchial chamber. This is the mouth. Then water, these are to be entered into the mouth by oral holes. When oral wall, these are to be open, water, these are to be entered into the mouth. Then water, these are to be entered into the pharynx region, and then it is to be entered into the, this is the branchial chamber or the gill chamber. In this branchial chamber or gill chamber, water, these are to be entered. Where gaseous section, these are to be takes place. These are the gill wrappers, and these are the C-shaped gill arch. On this gill arch, these pointed are the gill wrappers. And this is the gill arch, C-shaped. And on this gill arch, gill lamellae, these are to be broad. Gill lamellae, these are to be formed. And these gill lamellae, these are to be take part in the formation of gaseous section. This is the branchial chamber or the gill chamber. Inside this branchial chamber or gill chamber, these are the four gills, these are to be present, and these gills, these are to be take part in the active respiration, active gaseous action, these are to be takes place, gaseous action, these are to be occurs in this fish, that is valuable. Each gill head is covered by a thick connective tissue having mucous gland. Basophilic mast cells, undifferentiated connective tissue cells, and cuboidal cells. Each gill head is covered by thick connective tissue. Each gill having mucous gland with basophilic mast cells and undifferentiated connective tissue cells and cuboidal cells. All these cells, these parts, these are to present in the gill head. Each gill wrapper is long, slender, and toothed. Gill wrappers, these are to be curved from dorsal to ventral side. The gill wrappers are quite long and sharply pointed in the young fish, but as fish, these are to be increased their age, these gill wrappers, these are to be worn out with age and reduced in aged fish or the old fish. As continuous age is to be increasing and due to the working of these gill wrappers, these are to be reduced its size and its reducedness is to be decreased continuously. Hence, this gill wrapper, these are to be worn out with age and reduced in old fish. The gill wrappers form a sieve for the water current entering the gills, means those water is to be enter in the mouth, pharynx, and pharynx to the, that is the branchial chamber or the gill chamber. At that time, this gill chamber water which is to present, this water, these are to be filtered, this water, these are to be sieve for current, and this filtering is to be done, this filtration is to be done by gill wrapper. Since gill wrapper, these are to be most important to protect the gill filament from hard particles and tough materials which is to be enter inside the mouth region, inside the gill region. Gill wrappers don't permit the food particles to enter the gill chambers and direct the food towards the esophagus. Those food which is to be entered from mouth to the gill wrapper, these gill wrappers do not permit to enter the food particles or to enter the foods from the gill chamber, and this food, these are to be directed toward the alimentary canal, that is digestive tract, food toward the esophagus. This work is to be done by the this gill rackers, which is to present in the gill chambers, and hence due to this continuous working of gill rackers, it is to be worn out or it is to be reduced in size in old fish or the eyes fish. These are to increase the age. The branchial arch is supported by a number of branchiomeric muscles. The branchial arch is supported by a number of branchiomeric muscles like levator, then constrictors, hypobranchial and adductor muscles. These branchial arch is supported by a number of branchiomeric muscles. These branchiomeric muscles are levator, constrictors, hypobranchials and adductor muscles. These help the fish in controlling passage of the respiratory water. These help the fish in controlling passage of the respiratory water current out of the branchial cavity. Out of the branchial cavity, and these are to be help. These are to be important to controlling passage of the respiratory water current out of the branchial cavity. This is to be done by these different branchiomeric muscles, which is to present in the these gill arch. The primary gill lamella is borne on the gill ray, and the secondary gill filaments bore a series of transverse plates on the sides of the primary gill lamellae. These primary gill lamellae, these are to form a series of transverse plates on the sides of the primary gill filament. The secondary gill lamellae are thin walled and have an outer layer of respiratory epithelial cells and an inner vascular layer with scattered supporting cells. This scattered supporting cell is called as pilaster cells, and these pilaster cells, these are to present in the gill lamellae. These pilaster cells, these are to present in the gill filaments, and this is these pilaster cells, these are to be important in the vascular layer, and these are to be supporting for the respiratory epithelial. Blood is supplied to each gill by the afferent branchial artery. Blood is supplied to the each gill by an afferent branchial artery, which sends a branch to each gill filaments. The blood gets oxygenated when it passes through the capillaries of the filaments and then collected in a vessels that joins the efferent branchial artery. Means impure blood, these are to be supplied by afferent branchial arteries. Then in gill filaments, in branchial chamber, the blood is to be purified, dissolved, oxygen, these are to be absorbed, and carbon dioxide, these are to be diffused. Means gas blood gets deoxygenated. Those blood, these are to be deoxygenated, is to be oxygenated through the mechanism exchange, and these blood capillaries or these gill filament capillaries, they can exchange the gases. The gas from the blood diffuses, and gas from the water, these are to be absorbed, and these are to be absorbed gas, these are to be entered into the blood, and then this purified blood, these are to be provided to the efferent branchial artery. This efferent branchial artery then carry the oxygenated blood to the dorsal aorta and lateral aorta. Then this lateral aorta and dorsal aorta, these are to be supplied the these oxygenated blood or the pure blood to whole body. With this circulation, with this manner, blood, these are to be purified in the gills or the branchial chambers. And with this, we have seen in short, that is the structure of these gills, how the gaseous action, these are to be takes place, because inside when water, these are to be entered from mouth into the pharynx into this branchial chamber, no food material, these are to be passed, permit by these gill rackers are the red in color. These gill rackers, these are to, do not permit entering the food inside the branchial chamber, gill chamber, and these gill lamellae, these gill lamellae, these are to take part in the actual gaseous exchange. The gases which is to present in blood, these are to be diffused out, and gases which is to present in water, these are to be absorbed by gill filament. And in such exchange of gases, these are to take place inside the gill chamber and branchial chamber. Those gases which is to be absorbed by gill filament, then this gas, these are to be mixed into the blood, and then this blood, these are to be purified. This purified blood, these are to be collected by efferent branchial arteries, and this efferent branchial arteries, these are to be carry blood to the lateral artery and lateral artery to the dorsal artery to supply pure blood to the whole body part, to the whole body part, and impure blood, these are to be carried from heart from sinus venosus, auricle, ventricle to bulbous arteriosus, bulbous arterios to ventral aorta, and ventral aorta to the afferent branchial arteries for four afferent branchial arteries, these are to be arise, and these four afferent branchial arteries, these are to be carry, supply the impure blood for purification in gills or the branchial chamber. And in branchial chamber, gaseous exchange, these are to be takes place in blood. Carbon dioxide is to be more in concentration. This carbon dioxide, these are to be diffused in water, and in water more oxygen is to be present, dissolved oxygen. This more dissolved oxygen, these are to be absorbed by gill filament. Such exchange, these are to be takes place, and it is to be called as the respiration. It is specially called aquatic respiration. Such aquatic respiration, these are to takes place inside the branchial chamber or the gill chamber, and with this valley water, these are to be performed the aquatic respiration. Here we have seen only the structure of gills and the respiration, how respiration, these are to be takes place inside the gill chamber or the branchial chamber. In next part we have seen the mechanism of respiration. Thank you all of you.